السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. With the help and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we present to you Nasiha number 1107 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today is part 13 of the virtues of the Noble Quran. Our focus today is on Surah Yunus, and this is the 10th chapter and Surah of the Noble Quran. It was revealed before the Hijrah of Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Madinah Munawwara, hence it's classified as Makkiya. It comprises 109 verses. Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu salam's name means one who is familiar, and Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu salam, remember that this Surah 10, is dedicated after him, and his name is mentioned 4 times in the Noble Quran. So what is the virtue of the Surah? Almighty Allah sent Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu salam to a place called Ninwah, and there the people rebelled against him. He did not wait for the command of Allah, and he left them. And remember that he was swallowed by the fish. So Almighty Allah speaks of this in various places in the Noble Quran. And the verses in Surah Yunus that are very important, Almighty Allah speaks about who are the true awliyaullah. Allah, behold, remember, inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. For the special friends of Allah, that they are those people, there is no fear for them, and there is no sadness for them. And remember, Almighty Allah has given them special status. Who are the awliya Allah? Alladheena amanu wa kanu yattaqoon. They have true iman, and they have the quality of taqwa and true piety, Allah consciousness, in private, in public, all times, all places. In the Quran Sharif, we see 6 surahs and chapters are named after various Anbiya alayhimu salatu salam. Surah Nuh, so Nabi Nuh alayhi salatu salam, the surah is dedicated after him. Surah Ibrahim, Surah Hud, Surah Yunus, Surah Yusuf, and Surah Muhammad. Surah Muhammad is Surah 47. So 6 surahs named after mighty, mighty messengers of Almighty Allah, and the mightiest and greatest definitely is Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Similarly, we find in this surah, that is Surah Yunus, the wonderful dua which every Muslim should learn. There was so much torture, persecution, aggression, transgression against Nabi Musa, Nabi Harun alayhi salatu wasalam, and their people, the Bani Israel, by the Pharaoh and his cronies. So they asked Nabi Musa alayhi salam, they teach us something, some dua, and Almighty Allah revealed to him, and this is the dua there to read. Alallahi tawakkalna, Surah Yunus, chapter 10, verses 85-86. Upon Allah alone do we place our trust. Rabbana, la tajalna fitnatal lil qawmi zalimeen. O Allah, do not make us a trial and a test for a people and a nation who are the zalims, the oppressors and transgressors. Rabbana, la tajalna fitnatal lil qawmi zalimeen. Wa najjina bi rahmatika minal qawmi kafirin. And through your mercy, ya Allah, you save us, rescue us from a people who are the disbelievers. Lo and behold, the people read this dua, crying to Almighty Allah, and they would read salat in their homes. وَاجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً وَأَقِيمُ السَّلَاةِ. And you read your salat at home. So whatever salat they used to read, they would read, invoking, begging Almighty Allah, petitioning Allah. And then the day came when they had to go, and the Pharaoh and his army followed them, and Almighty Allah liberated and rescued them, and they were the ones, remember, that they saw the Pharaoh and his cronies, how they drowned. And Nabi Yunus alayhi salatu salam, remember, while he was in the belly of the fish, he had to read the dua abundantly, taught to him by Almighty Allah, La ilaha illa anta subhanak, inni kuntu mina zalimeen. And when he read it abundantly, lo and behold, Almighty Allah rescued him. Salaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.